In metaphysics, the question has come up again and again, if we have no real free will, why does the law of karma exist at all? How can you be punished and rewarded for something over which you have no control? The answer is very surprising. The spiritual answer is very surprising. The spiritual answer is, your free will does not operate independent of the Creator's will. At the end of the spiritual journey, you discover that your experienced free will was no different than the Creator's will. You could not have the experience of that free will except if the Creator had that will. Therefore, there is no difference. But you only realize it when you are at the other end, not here. When you are here, it looks like an individual free will of an individual. All free wills operate within the will of the Creator. Therefore, they are free. The Creator's will is free. To that extent, when you realize that your free will is operating within the will of the Creator and His will is free, your will becomes free and no longer an illusion. On the other hand, what about karma then? Well, if free will is illusion, karma is illusion too. That's the other beauty. Karma is not real. No soul has ever undergone any karma. Karma is a mental experience. Karma is created by the mind, suffered by the mind, enjoyed by the mind. It's a mental game. When you rise above the mind and become yourself, there's no karma at all. You find you are never given any karma, nor did you create any karma. You are created, you are given a device, a thinking device, a device which experiences free will. And through that device, you experience punishment and reward. Therefore, the whole package of experience of free will, the experience of karma, good and bad, punishment and reward, the whole thing is a single package and operates only in the three worlds of this physical world, the astral world and the causal world. It does not go into the spiritual world at all. In the spiritual world, there is neither mind nor karma, nor punishment, nor reward. This is all a local thing here, generated for our experience here. It does not belong to us. It's temporary. We took it on, wore a costume on a stage, so that we can act well and enjoy the act. We have to take it off. When we go home, we don't carry it with us. We don't carry any karma with us when we go home. Our true home lies beyond the mind, and therefore lies beyond karma. So the answer is very beautiful, that while we are here in the physical body, the experience of karma becomes real, the experience of free will becomes real, the experience of seeking becomes real, the experience of being found by a perfect living master becomes real. The whole show takes place in such a beautiful, real way that there is no way that we can ever doubt its reality.